parishes in the Victoria Deanery are invited to gather at 2 p.m. in St. Mary's Catholic Church for confessions, as well as adoration, prayer, and song before the Most Blessed Sacrament. Please check the bulletin for more information. As a kind reminder, we ask that you turn your cell phones to silent. Good morning and welcome to the Cathedral of Our Lady of Victory as we celebrate the Feast of Divine Mercy on this second Sunday of Easter. The processional hymn is number 326, I Know What My Redeemer Lives, number 326.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
On the second Sunday of Easter, it is Divine Mercy Sunday. Every day God is merciful to us. On this particular day, we thank God in a special way for the mercy that he brings to us in Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. We gather around the altar of the Lord Jesus and we join with the children, our third of five First Communion classes that are receiving First Holy Communion this weekend at three of our weekend masses. And so we join with them and their parents and grandparents and all who celebrate this special day with them. We gather with those also who join us in this mass by means of television. We pray in a special way for the sick, the homebound, those in nursing centers and hospitals, that God's healing love and presence will be with them. And for the times that we have failed to gratefully receive the mercy of God, for the times that we have failed to share it with each other, We ask that God forgive us. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, her Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast kindle the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. They devoted themselves to the teaching of the apostles and to the communal life, to the breaking of bread, and to the prayers. All came upon everyone, and many wonders and signs were done through the apostles. All who believed were together and had all things in common. They would sell their property and possessions and divide them among all according to each one's need. Every day they devoted themselves to meeting together in the temple area and to breaking bread in their homes. They ate their meals with exaltation and sincerity of heart, praising God and enjoying favor with all the people. And every day the Lord added to their number those who were being saved. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in his great mercy gave us a new birth to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you, who by the power of God are safeguarded through faith, to a salvation that is ready to be revealed in the final time. In this you rejoice, although now for a little while you may have to suffer through the various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith, more precious than gold that is perishable, even though tested by fire, may prove to be for praise, glory, and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Although you have not seen him, you love him. Even though you do not see him now, yet believe in him. You rejoice with an indescribable and glorious joy as you attain the goal of your faith, the salvation of your souls. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
Your
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retained are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in the book. But these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord. It is wonderful on this Divine Mercy Sunday that we join with you, children, as you receive your first Holy Communion. We thank your parents and grandparents and your godparents and your wonderful teachers that have helped to prepare you for this moment. And to know that this is an exciting time for all of us, so that when we witness a child receiving Holy Communion, we are reminded of our own first Holy Communion. And we are reminded of how important communion, Jesus, the bread of life, the Eucharist, is for all of us who believe. And so we pray God's blessings upon you. And to you parents, to know that you help your children to come to know Jesus. Your house, your home, your family is the domestic church. It's referred to as the first church of children, the little church. And when your little church, when your family is strong, then our parish family, our parish church is strong. And the Diocese of Victoria is strong. And the Universal Church is strong. And that's why the first and the primary educators of their children in the ways of faith are always parents. The church stands ready to help you, to give you what you need in your role, but never to usurp that role. And so it's so important that we continue and you continue to form your children in the ways of faith. The best way, of course, is setting a good example, of which is the responsibility for all of us. And then keeping your family strong and bringing your children to Mass every Sunday so that they have the opportunity to receive Jesus Christ, our bread of life, our nourishment, our food, every single week, if not even more often than that. Because they need Jesus, they need that nourishment, just as we need Jesus. And this beautiful solemnity that we celebrate in this time of Easter, of what is referred to as Divine Mercy Sunday, reminds us of the mercy of Jesus Christ to all the world. We hunger for that mercy. We cry out for that mercy. And God has heard our plea. He has sent to us Jesus, who has risen from the dead. He has sent to us the forgiveness of our sins. And what Jesus has done for us on the cross in forgiving us, he asked that we do the same. And so a very important part of every family and every individual Christian's life is to be a merciful person, not to judge, not to accuse, not to gossip about, but to have mercy upon, to correct when correction is needed, to reach out in love to those who have fallen away, to help those who have turned to sin to come to find the light again, but always, always, always being merciful. For as Jesus is merciful to us, and as we share that same mercy with each other, we all grow stronger. We can understand then that that enables us to recognize Jesus in the breaking of the bread. It helps us to recognize in our marriages, in our family life, in what we do every day as followers of Jesus, as believers, of how we are to be merciful. And then we all become stronger. And we give these children and all children the example of faith that they deserve, the example of faith that they need. Let us rejoice in Jesus, the bread of life, and let us be merciful to each other as he is merciful to us. And gathered together in the mercy of Christ, we profess what we believe as his followers. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God, eternal, begotten, not made, consubstantial,
by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin and became a man. For our sake, Jesus Christ, our Lord Jesus Christ, he suffered death on the third day, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds with the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is glorified, and was spoken to the prophets. I believe in the one who we have apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
On this Divine Mercy Sunday, we cry out in faith, Jesus, I trust in you. And in that trust, we turn to the Lord and ask that he answer our prayers.
For Pope Francis and all leaders at every level of our church, may their example encourage us to grow in faith, believing even though we haven't seen. We pray to the Lord. For all nations in conflict, may God's mercy protect all people in distress because of war, especially those driven by desperation to seek refuge in other lands. We pray to the Lord. For all who listen to God's word today, may we learn from the early Christians' example and share what we have for the benefit of all. We pray to the Lord. For those who have no faith, those who have lost their faith, and those whose faith is faltering, may they see and experience the mercy of Christ through our actions. We pray to the Lord. For those newly baptized into our church, and for all who are celebrating their first communion, may they continue to grow in the love of Christ. We pray to the Lord. For the family and friends of Leroy Mikeeter and Monsignor Thomas McLaughlin, may they be consoled in their grief by the Lord. We pray to the Lord. For all the faithful departed, and for the repose of the soul of Leonard Mazigemba, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord. For the needs listed in our parish intention book, and for those we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, in the joy of this time of Easter, we rejoice in the mercy your Son Jesus brings to us. We seek to trust in him above all else, and so in that trust, in growing deeper in our faith, we will see the importance of being merciful to each other. And we ask, Father, that you answer these prayers through Christ our Lord.
The hymn for the presentations of the gifts is number 330, Ye Sons and Daughters, number 330.
Thank you. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people and of those you have brought to new birth, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Lord, have mercy.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Brendan, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord.
The communion hymn is number 324, Love Divine, All Loves Excelling, number 324.
Love Divine.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Alleluia, alleluia.
Our recessional hymn is also number 324, Love Divine, All Loves Excelling, number 324.